Right, what's up YouTube? Got a new video for you. I'm going to be showing you how to use any USB controller through your PC over your Wi-Fi connection to control your Android device like your phone, your Yinlips or your JXD players. Really useful actually, because as you know, some of them don't have Bluetooth and also they don't have USB on the go, or you can't get USB on the go working properly. So the first thing you want to do before you start is plug in your USB controller. I've got an adapter going over a Wi-Fi controller, but still. Anyway, and wait until the driver's installed. Once they've installed, you want to go to Google. You want to type Joy2Key. It's the first site you come to. It's the English version. And scroll down to the bottom. Download Joy2Key. Extract it to your desktop, so you get this. Right, it's not an installation file, it just runs straight off the bat. So you click it like this, and as you can see, I've already got a Joypad 1 plugged in. I've already actually mapped the buttons, but I'll show you what you have to do. So basically what you do is you'd click on there, press left, okay, right, okay, up, and down. Right, once you've done this, if you come down to button one and then go to auto setting wizard, it says push the key for joystick one, button one. So in other words, what I'll do is I'll just use numbers 1 to 9. I'm only going to do a setup for the very standard PlayStation controller. I'm not going to bother with analog. Analog does work, but I don't want to make this video too long. So what you do is you go 1, then you press next one, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 0. Right, then exit. So then minimize that down into the background. So that's more or less the PC side of it done. We'll come back to that after when I show you it.
Right, now to set up the Android side of things, you need to go to the market, Google Play, type in Wi-Fi keyboard, download it, install it the usual way. It's free, don't cost you nothing. Then what you need to do, straight after that, you go into settings, go to language and keyboard, and then check Wi-Fi keyboard. Alright, so then you get your warning. Alright, then you go back. Alright, what I'll do is I always load up the market, because you need some sort of input text field to change the input method. So what I'll do is I always load up the market. Maybe not. Let's try again. Click on the search and it brings up this big text box. Then what I do is I just press home, then I load up Wi-Fi keyboard, and then you get this message saying connect your computer browser to this IP address and port number. Alright, so before anything, that's what we need to do. So I'm going to go back to the PC, show you that what the web page looks like and what you need to do, and then we should be good to go, and we'll be able to play our favourite games through PlayStation emulator, N64, SNES, you name it.
Okay, right, back on the other side. This is the last bit you've got to do to make sure we've got a connection between our Yinlips Android device via the web browser. Wi-Fi keyboard tells you to punch in an IP address at the top of your web browser. Do what it tells you to do, click on game mode, key codes only, and then make sure that this little flashing cursor in this little box stays like that, and you leave your web browser open. As you can see up here, it says connected. And then after that, I'll actually show you it in action. This is not my idea, it's nearly 2 years old. It's by a guy named Duobix. I posted the video up in the forum. It's just that the audio wasn't very clear on his video, and I thought I'd try and show you how to do it, because we're all going to benefit from it. where we haven't got USB on the go, Bluetooth, like I said earlier on. Alright, so enjoy the next part of the video of Wi-Fi keyboard in action.
Right, now to show you this in action, I've not set up like an enter button so I could just click on the PlayStation emulator. What I'll do is I'm going to do it manually on my Yinlip screen and then I'll be back. As you can see, it's working perfect with the controller, just like we wanted it to. So I'm going to click on a game there. And there you go, that's my controller over Wi-Fi controlling my Yinlips G16 I'm actually using to do this video, but it will work on any Android device with Wi-Fi. So, happy gaming. I hope this video was useful to you. Sorry if I've made a few mistakes. I'm sure you'll comment on the loud button bashing and etc. Any questions, see me on Dingunity forums, and if you're having any problems, I'll see if I can help you. Bye for now.